ask you what you want from me this year. Your tears came crashing down. Oh, I know what I've been promised.
Hello, season greetings from Robert's Reading Room and Reviews. I'm here to drop another book review. I would like to say I've read several books by this author. It took me a while to read this author because I went off on hearsay. A lot of people I come in contact that was a reader like I am, and I talk with them, they'll be like, ooh, she's so nasty, ooh, she dirty, she this, she that. You know, and at the time, I wasn't into erotica. And even now, I read it. But, you know, if it doesn't have a mean storyline with it, I too much don't care for it. I mean, that's just me, personally. And then I had a chance to meet her in 2015 here in Atlanta at an awards show. It was hosted by Tammy Newhouse. I think it's just the AMC something. Very lovely lady. I actually had one of her books that was made into a movie, and I had it for like 4 or 5 years, and I would not read that book until I knew the release date of the movie and when it was coming out, because I wanted to read the book right before I went to go see the movie, and that's what I did. But I'm talking about no other than the queen of erotica to me, Zane, and I'll Be Home for Christmas. It's a short novella, very short. You can probably read this in 30 minutes or less, according on how fast you read. It deals with Noelle. It's the main character who leaves home, and she stayed gone from home for like 10 plus years with her fiance, boyfriend, Reno. I'm going to say Reno. And she leaves home because she wound up, as a young teenager, she wound up getting pregnant, and she was ashamed, so they left and moved to New York, and they struggled. He wound up passing, so she wound up coming back home, and you would think that she would get open arms for coming back home, her family, but her mother's the only one welcoming her with open arms. Her father, her sister, Carolyn, not so much at first. And her little niece, you know, had open arms for her also. But she wound up explaining to her father, you know, what happened and why she left. So he wound up forgiving her, and, you know, they cried together and they wound up forgiving her. And that's what I got from this book, is no matter what you got going on, family, friends, or whatnot, this is the time to spend time with your loved one, your friends, and just be thankful and cherish this. Because, you know, some people may not live to see Christmas, just like today, that tragedy that happened in the state of Washington with the Amtrak train. Those people who lost their lives, that is just so horrible, especially when we a couple days away from Christmas. So what I got from this book is that it's never too late to forgive, so forgive. And sometimes it's hard for me because I do hold grudges sometimes. But I'm trying to overcome that and be a better person. And that you can forgive, but you can't forget. So that's what I take away from this book. Please, if you haven't, check Zane out. I mean, she's a great writer. I love her work. I even had a chance to see some of her sex chronicles that was on TV at one point. I think they may still be on demand, if I'm not for sure. I'm not forgetting. Anyway, I just want to say I give this book 5 stars. It was quick, straight to the point, and I love that. Please, if you haven't, pick it up. It's on Amazon. It's free, too. I'll Be Home for Christmas by Zane. It's a short story. And I just want to thank everyone who support my YouTube channel, Robert's Reading Room and Reviews. Also on Facebook, it's open to the public. You don't have to join the group if you don't want to. If you have any questions, recommend a book, or anything. And please, if you like this video, hit the ring. Give me thumbs up. Anytime you want to see me, alert, hit the bell button on the side there on my YouTube channel. I just want to say, I give this book, like I said again, 5 stars. And until next time, I hope you have a great evening.
What's in your mind? This year won't let you down. Even if the snow falls, even if the roads close, you won't be alone now. Even if it's so cold, as far as the north goes, just wait under the mistletoe. I'm coming home. That would be the best gift.